In this video, I will be explaining level negative 7 of the Backrooms, also known as the Dinner Party, which is what I think to be the scariest negative level that I've ever gone over so far. This is a disturbing place in a really morbid and guttural physical way, and viewer discretion is advised because this is about to get nasty. Without any more talking from my end, let's get into the video, shall we? Backrooms level negative 7 has been given a classification of a class 5 difficulty and is heavily unsafe. The level itself is stable, and there's really one single entity that calls this place home. His name is Johnny, and we'll get into him later, I promise. The level is highly dangerous and should be avoided at all costs, but if you or another wanderer find yourself stuck in it, you're gonna have to watch this video to figure out how to escape. It takes the appearance of an extensive and winding set of hallways and rooms that appear to be from a house complex. The house itself is non-linear, which means the layout and the design makes no sense, and the hallway's physical spaces do not follow any physics from real life. The hallways seem to wrap around a central location inside the level, which is known as the dining room. Now, the dining room is a horrifying place with deeply disturbing descriptions given, and if you find yourself walking around the hallways and you end up in this dining room place, you're gonna wanna run away as fast as you can. The dining room looks just like an empty room with a table in the middle of it. The room is barely lit up with a dull overhead light, and just be warned, what I'm about to describe is grotesque. On the table in the dining room, you will see disembodied heads on the plates. The plates themselves are set a few inches apart from each other, and the heads on them are all different, and they're all on different levels of decay. Obviously, I can't show the full image because YouTube would probably slap me in the face and delete my channel. So you're gonna have to imagine, use your imagination, you know? But the heads are thought to belong to the unfortunate wanderers who made it to the dining room and didn't leave in time before he got to them. Again, I'll explain him later, him being Johnny, but just know never to stay in this dining area for a prolonged time, and never make any loud noises to attract Johnny, unless you want your head on a platter. The main characteristic of these hallways and rooms are that they're shrouded in a dark mist. Now, it's not that the level itself is actually dark. It's that the darkness seems to be real here. You can kind of feel when you cross over into it. It feels like mist or a fog in the morning. Anyways, this darkness and this physical lack of light floats around the basement and covers different parts at different times of the level. There are occasionally light switches on the walls here, but it is imperative that you never turn on the lights. Ever. Never do it, because turning on the light switch would reveal your location to Johnny, which is, of course, the worst thing you could do to yourself. It is possibly the worst fate in the Backrooms, actually. It is important to note that this level is not infinite, nor is it very large. It's a finite place with only a select few floors and hallways and rooms to explore. The level's ambience is not absolute silence. There's actually a strange collection of sounds constantly echoing through the carpeted hallways. You cannot really refer to it as music because it's not really like musical. It's more like random notes and sounds playing in an unnatural and liminal way. Anyways, the sound is constantly beeping overhead, and it's really the only thing that you can hide under from making noise to not attract Johnny. I mentioned just now that the level is multiple stories, and that's true, and there are different sets of staircases that you can take up or down to get to the two other floors. All three different floors have unique styles and design decorations, but they all follow the same house, hallway, and room style that the entire level does. When you walk up or down one of these staircases to get to the other two floors, the way you came from will shut and go away behind you, essentially forcing you to walk through this new floor until you find the exit back where you came from. In total, there are three zones per the first two floors, and the final third floor has one single zone. This is referred to as the end zone. Now, the end zone is not actually a real zone you're going to explore. It's more of just a big room with a door on the other end. The door is locked until you find the key to unlock it, and the key itself is randomly placed inside the rest of the level. The rooms in this level are empty and they're plain. Usually at most there might be a desk or a bed or a chair or some other random piece of furniture, but all of it seems to be from real life. Keep these furniture pieces in your mind because you might have to hide under them to evade Johnny. The hallways on these floors seem to shift when you're not looking, which adds to that non-linear nature that I mentioned earlier. This makes it really hard to map out where you're headed or where you're going to be, so just think of these hallways as a Rubik's Cube that can shift. This is very important because you might find yourself running away or trying to hide from Johnny, and the hallway switch could be to your advantage or be to your detriment. It could bring Johnny closer. This Johnny figure that I keep mentioning is horrifying, and I'm about to explain it right now. The entity is only referred to as Johnny because there are strange invitations scattered around different levels of the Backrooms, inviting people to Johnny's dinner party, and this level is the dinner party. He's the reason for those disembodied heads on the table, and is also the reason you should never turn the lights on in the halls, unless you just don't want to be alive. Physically, Johnny seems to be a shadowy, dark entity of an unknown physical size. Most people that see him really don't survive the encounter to give accurate details, but from the few that have, or the few that have pictured him, he seems to be a grotesque, dark shape with large white eyes. He smells of rot and decay, and he behaves very sadistically and malevolently. Johnny can sense when lights turn on in this level, and the second one does, he will sprint at an unnaturally quick pace to that location. That's how he hunts. He seems to mainly hang out in that dining room area where those heads are at the center of the level. So if you wander that room, or if you accidentally get there on purpose, it'll be the last thing you do, most likely. Johnny's attacks are vicious and aggressive, and he will slash and bite and do anything in order to despawn you or his victims. After this, he will then take their head back to the table for display. He kind of seems to feed off of fear. It is unknown if Johnny is some kind of mutated entity, like a wretch or a hound or a redkin, or what his true form is. But since the level is covered in this misty darkness, and Johnny's full body has never been seen, we can just guess that he looks gross, because he smells gross. Whatever or whoever it is, he does not like letting people visit the level, and will do anything to get your head on his table. If you want to survive this level, and Johnny specifically, you need to do the following. If you hear footsteps outside of a room that you're in, you need to hide quickly and quietly. If the music on this level stops playing while you're exploring, you also need to hide. This means that the entity Johnny is nearby. This creature as a whole strikes fear into thousands of wanderers inside the Backrooms. He's very taboo, very scary, and many people won't even go near this level because of how dangerous Johnny is. The only good news is that Johnny's eyesight seems to be bad because he's used to the darkness, so he relies so much on hearing and smell to hunt you down. This is where hiding under that furniture might save your life, because he might not be able to see you under there. To enter the level, you have to touch a piece of paper on any other level that reads, "You've been invited," inviting the reader to Johnny's special dinner event. If you find this invite, you can noclip through it to come here, but if you also find it, you should shred it and never touch it again, because it would be the worst thing you could do to yourself. To exit the level, you need to search the different rooms of this level to find these magnetic key fragments that all come together to make a full key to use to unlock the door in the end zone. Now, the end zone is at the top floor of the level, it's the third and final one. You have to unlock the door on the other side of the room in the end zone to escape. The only problem is, some of these key fragments might be in very dark places, so you might have to use a light to find them. And what did I tell you about lights? They attract Johnny. So you have to do it for a split second, maybe 1 or 2 seconds at max, if you want to survive. That way Johnny doesn't have time to react. This level is truly horrifying, and it really seems to be a morbid reminder of how dangerous the Backrooms is and how little we understand it. It's one of those levels that sends a cold chill down your spine after you read it, and it makes you physically sick reading through the descriptions, specifically about Johnny's victims. But I think this is a great example of the Backrooms horror, and even though it's really scary, I think it's downright an amazing level, and I hope you enjoyed it.